Chapter 13, Measurement. This chapter, we will learn how to measure objects, whether it's their height, it's their weight, how long, how tall, how short, or even the same sizes. Okay, we are going to learn a lot of things in here, so make sure you have your right measuring tools to measure stuff on your book. Okay, so right here I'm going to show you some samples that I found, and it is on this sheet right here. Okay, on the very top we are going to, it says, I'm just going to show you some samples. Right here, circle the picture that is longer and circle the object that is short, cross out the object that is shorter. Circle long, cross out shorter. And right here, as you can see, we have two pictures here. Which one do you think is longer? The top or the bottom? Okay, the top, very good. So we're going to circle it. And then right here is shorter. So we are going to cross it out. So circle, cross it out. How about this clip? Which one is longer, the top or the bottom? Good job, it is the bottom. And then we are going to cross out the top because it's shorter. Now how about these two? They have the same length. Okay, no one is shorter and no one is longer. So we're gonna circle both. Right here, can you tell me which one is longer, the top or the bottom? Okay, very good, the bottom. And which one is shorter? The top, very good, so we crossed them out. Right here on the second, we are going to compare which one is taller on in height. Okay, they circle the tall and cross out the short. And then we are going to circle both objects that are the same height. Look at the globe. Okay, we're going to circle which one is taller, the left or the right. The left is taller, cross out the shorter. How about this one, the timer? Which one is taller, left or right? The one is on the right, very good. And we are going to cross out the shorter. Look at the broom, which one is taller, the left or the right? Circle the right because it's taller, cross out the left because it's shorter. How about these two glue bottles? Is it one of them was shorter and taller? No, they have both the same height, so we are going to circle both. How about the clipboard? Which one is taller, the ones on the left or on the right? The one that is on the left. So we're going to circle that and cross out the one on the right because it is shorter. Now, next box is about the length again. How long? But this time we use cubes to measure this one. Okay, right here we just look at our eye so we can tell which one is shorter, longer, taller in our picture or the same height. Right here we are going to use cubes to measure the object. Okay, the pencil, look at this pencil. Right here we use 1, 2, 3, 4 cubes to measure this pencil. From that end to this end we use 4 cubes. So that is right, they write number four for us. Now how about we will do the rest of them. How many cubes we use to measure this pencil, okay? Remember, you have to look from the end to the end. Okay, so this is the beginning and this is the end of your pencil. So we use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cubes. So let's go ahead and write 6. How about this pencil? Look at the end. Okay, in the beginning, okay? So how many cubes did we use here? 1, 2, 3, very good. We use 3 cubes. How about this pencil? How many cubes did we use? Okay, I'm gonna look at the beginning of my eraser all the way to the end of my pencil and how many cubes did I use? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very good. So write 5. That's how long the pencil is. Now on the bottom is how tall the height of our plants. The first one is already done for us. They gave us 1, 2, 3. That's the roots. And that's how tall that flower is. And we use 1, 2, 3 cubes. Very good. How about on this one? Look at the roots. We're going to start from here, the bottom, all the way to the top. How many cubes did we use? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very good. 5 cubes. Good job. Now, how about here? Okay. Look at from the beginning and count how many we use to measure this flower. 1, 2, 3, 4. Very good. So write 4. Oh, little tiny one. How many cubes did we use to measure this little tiny flower? 1, 2. Very good. So write 2. That's a sample. That's the first sample that I can show you. But right here, I have another sample. We looked at the first paper with how tall, how long, or the same size. Right here, I have 2 pictures that it tells me which one is heavier and which one is lighter. An ounce is light. Pounds, it's heavy. Like if you compare about the cotton and the crayon. So this one based on where the cotton is because it's just light and you can put your crayons on the heavy part. So this is an ounce and this is a pound. So you guys, babies, newborns are ounces and you, some of them were pounds, but not that heavy. And you are heavier than the babies, so you have to use the pound side. Okay, so there's another way how to measure things. We now talk about how to measure weight and height and length or the same size. Now, this time we are going to talk about this one. Who can tell me what is this? This is called the ruler. Very good. And hopefully that you have this at your house because you are going to measure a lot of things with this ruler. So right here, I'm going to show it to you that we are going to learn only the inches part of it. We are going to learn just the big spaces right here on the top. So if you have the ruler and if you are reading the right word right here, you are on the right side of our ruler. If it is upside down, you're using the wrong side. You're using the centimeter or the millimeter. Okay. I just want you to learn the inches for now. And our ruler, we have 12 inches. From here, this is the line. This is the beginning. I know some of you were measured from this side. No, this is where your finger is. That's going to be how you hold your paper, your ruler, so that you can measure the object from this line. To here is 1 inch. From here to here is 2 inches. So we're going to begin from this line, not at the end of this ruler. No, that's where you hold it. Right here, that is your end. That's your beginning. That's where we start measuring things. So this is your ruler. We have this line to this is called 1 inch. So right here, 1 inch, 2 inches, 3 inches, 4 inches, 5 inches, 6 inches, 7 inches, 8 inches, 9 inches, 10 inches, 11 inches, and then 12 inches. So we have a foot. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to measure the lines. For now, I have this for you to look at. So right here, I have this line as my beginning. And then I am going to measure how long, how many inches is this line. So I'm going to use the inches side, this side, the bigger side, not the small part. So I will put my ruler, remember we talked about, okay, I am not going to start right here or I will not get the right answer. So remember, there is no line there. I have to start where the line is, right here. So now I am going to read how many inches this line have. So I'm going to have it from here, 1. That's 1 right here. And then right here is the end, it's 2. So this line is 2 inches. Now let's go to the next line. Not this way, boys and girls. You're going to get the wrong answer. You have to start with that line. Okay, see the beginning line right there? Because right here is where your finger, when you're going to hold this ruler. So now how many inches is this line? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I see 5 inches in this line. So let's go ahead and write 5. Now how about this line? Okay, this is not the way how we measured this line. Make sure you find the right line to begin. Okay, always look at this side where to start. So right here is your line. It's right there. So I have now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I found 8 inches in this line. So go ahead, write 8. Oh, this is a hard one. Oh, I don't know how long is this. What do you think, guys? How long this line be? You are right. It's too short. It's only 1 inch. Very good. How about the next line? How many inches could this be? Let me see. Okay, we have from here to here. I need to see, make sure that I am on the right end. Okay, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is long. I found 9 inches. So go ahead and write 9. Next, how many inches do you think is this? Let me see. Okay, remember the line starts right there. Okay, not that end. This end, the line. 1, 2, 3. Very good. I see 3 inches. Nice. How about this line? How many inches is this? How many? Okay, very good. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 inches. Very good. You are smarter than me, boys and girls. Now, right here, I have another sample on how to look at how to measure things. Okay, and we are going to help me write the answer on the bottom. Okay, this pencil, okay, this is where it starts and ends right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 inches. That is 6 inches long. This crayon starts from the zero, not from the end. This is zero right here. We have 3 inches. Very good. How about this one? From that end to this end, we have 4 inches. That end to this end, we have 5. Very good. And this little tiny crayon, we have 2. Very good. Now, I would like you to help me on how to measure this pen by using this cube. Can I use just 1 cube? Is it enough to measure my pencil? Nah. How about if I'm going to put 3 more? Now I have 4 cubes. Is it enough to measure it? Nah. How about I'm going to add 2 more? Let me see if I can put 2 more. Okay, if I have 2 more, what do you think? Is it enough to measure my pen? No. Let me see. I put 2 more right there. Now let me check and see if how many cubes did we use to measure this pen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wow! We use 8 cubes to measure this pen. How about this marker? And this time I'm going to use the paper clips. Now how many paper clips do you think will I use to measure this marker from that end? Is it 1's enough? Nah. How about that? Is it 2 enough? No. How about another? Is it 3? Yes, you are right. I use 3 paper clips to measure that marker. Cool. Well, how about this post-it note? Little tiny thing. How many do you think? How many inches could that be? If I'm going to use my ruler. I have 1, 2. Wow, you guys were really awesome. I can't wait for you boys and girls to learn on how to measure things all around us. See you next time.